Hey, Mom, I got a book from the library and a new stalker. Hey, everybody, I'm Shanae, and welcome to Ask Firefox, where we help answer some of the great mysteries of our modern world of tech. Maybe you've heard of us, but Firefox has been around the internet block. Like, we're talking 90s, okay? So let's dive into this Q&A. Question one, should I be worried when connecting to school Wi-Fi? Can I get hacked? First off, whether you're at school or a library, there's a terms of service you'll have to agree to. That TOS has tons of fine print that usually boils down to, we're watching everything you do. But hey, if you need to get on Wi-Fi, you need to get on. So let's say you agree and you get connected. Well, guess what? Your device has an identifier called an IP address, which is unique to each device. And when you connect online, it's brought into a virtual public space where a bunch of other people are just chilling. Make sure the websites you're visiting are secure, so those packets are encrypted and harder for others to get a hold of. One easy way to check? Just look at the URL. It should start with HTTPS, not just HTTP. If it doesn't, it's not secure. And those packets are at risk by a bunch of nosy neighbors that could have at them. That's what's known as packet sniffing. To avoid this, we recommend using a VPN, or virtual private network. This software masks your IP. It basically means you're hidden from potential hackers, government spies, corporations trying to get your data. We've also got our own VPN, which we think is pretty awesome, and there's a free trial. But feel free to comparison shop and watch out for anything that sounds too good to be true. If it's a free service, chances are they're doing some data collecting of their own. Ooh, which kind of defeats the purpose of a VPN, hmm? All right, next question. I was doing some research on a subject and now I'm getting a bunch of ads for it. How do I stop that from happening? Even if you're using a VPN, which would mask your device and your IP, it can't help you if you're logged into an account on a website that's using cookies. Now, cookies is something you need to watch out for. But I like cookies, especially when they're all crusty on the outside and gooey on the inside. Not those kind of cookies. Cookies are little internet trackers used by websites to remember all sorts of things about what we're doing on the internet. Third-party cookies are taking bits and pieces of what they want to learn from you and putting it together to form a profile on you. With every little press of the keyboard and click of the mouse, they can get a hint of what you like, who you are, what you're shopping for, and what your boyfriend or girlfriend might want for Christmas. So what? Why should I care? Best case scenario, you just start getting a bunch of targeted ads. Worst case, you get sucked into all those ads, and you can't stop buying. And the next thing you know, there goes your savings for that brand new console, or that fun summer trip with your BFFs. And now all of a sudden, you're the cheapskate in the group, and nobody invites you anywhere, because they don't want to have to pay for you to get into the club. Look, if you don't mind someone following you around virtually everywhere, taking notes and putting up banners of everything you do on the web, well, great. Hope that goes well for you. But if you want to protect yourself, then turn off those third-party cookies. Sheesh. Some browsers are now being proactive about banning cookies by default. In Firefox, we have a feature called Total Cookie Protection, which does a lot of the work for you. If you use Firefox, we've got an awesome browser extension called Multi-Account Containers, which takes all those cookies and puts them into separate virtual cookie jars. It helps keep your work accounts and personal accounts separate. And whenever you're done with one of those containers, just hit delete. Ta-da! Those trackers are now gone. All right, last question. I have logins for my personal email, my school email, a portal to turn in assignments. It goes on and on. What's the easiest way to remember all those passwords? Yikes, been there. One site is like, must use lowercase, uppercase, special characters. Next site, 12 characters long. Next, no special characters. What a Sam Hill? I have like 20 variations of 10 different passwords. And then I'm getting locked out of my own bank account because you know you only get 5 attempts. Having complex passwords and different ones for different logins is a good thing. Just utilize some tools to help you keep track. The most comprehensive method is Password Manager. Some browsers have one built in, like Firefox. In fact, it can even suggest a password for you, so you don't have to think of one. And if you go this route, you can even use Firefox Monitor. That'll alert you if your password shows up on the dark web. Other ones, like 1Password, work across multiple browsers and platforms, so you can access it on all of your devices or browsers, whenever you need it. Alrighty then, class, we went over a lot today. How to stay hidden on public Wi-Fi, who's eating all my digital cookies, and how to manage all those passwords. Some of this takes a little bit of work to set up and learn, but it's totally worth it. So, who's got questions? Oh, a lot of you.
Me.
Oh, that's why we're here. Leave us a comment below or hit us up on social. We're on Instagram and Twitter, @Firefox. If you found this video helpful, make sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe for new videos every week. Until next time, I'm Shanae. Thanks for watching. Cheerio.